I love all the food she's talking about. So we're with Heather Pierce from Blount Memorial, and she's sharing four types of foods to boost your memory. I need all of these, especially with the early morning hours. So
we all can relate to this.
Yes, so. I need to incorporate a lot more of these.
Right, and overall, just a healthy lifestyle can help the brain age gracefully, we'll call it. But you know, there are some foods that we can do to maybe boost that too. So one in particular, anything like the DHA, docosahexaenoic acid, that sounds really big. That's one of our fish oils that is really, it's most abundant in our brain, so it makes sense to have some of this in our diet. Mm-hmm. And you've heard of the two servings of fish a week, that would be good enough. Mm-hmm. Usually things like salmon, tuna, mackerel, herring, those are the richest sources.
Okay.
And you know, I did bring a pouch of salmon because, hey, it's easy.
Exactly.
Why not? Also eggs, the yolk in eggs, and some are higher in DHA than the others, but those are really good to have in our diet. Now there are some alternative sources that are vegetarian sources of fish oil, but they're not all created equal. Mm-hmm. They have that what's called ALA. So ALA does convert to DHA in our body, but as we age, it kind of declines too.
Okay.
So it is important to get some DHA sources if you possibly can. That's why some folks are recommended to have a fish oil supplement too, because that is a good way to get it in. But that's, I just like to go over that because, you know, the flaxseed, chia seed, walnuts are great additional sources too.
Yes, so they're so easy to add into different recipes.
Absolutely, you can just throw chia seeds.
You made granola
bars
here one day, and they had all of those things in them.
Yeah, that's from the same recipe.
Yeah,
so,
there you go.
And I've been making those, by the way.
Good memory. I'm working on it.
Yes. And as far as the dark berry color, your blues, and you know that there's a type of flavonoid in those that are really protective of our heart. And as well as brain, so it helps with blood flow. So if your brain's getting blood, hey, that's a good thing too for memory. So a lot of these things that we're talking about for brain health, certainly great for heart health as well.
It's just getting to be like prime season for a lot of these darker berries.
Yes. Throw them in your salad. Just pack them as snacks. Mm-hmm. You know, they're great for a lot of different things. And in the winter, the dried stuff can come in handy too.
That's exactly right. And then my favorite, I'm a huge veggie fan. I was telling you I could probably get a whole plate of cooked cabbage. So these offer the same benefits?
Well, cruciferous vegetables are very protective of the brain as well. So things like cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, those are the big ones. And you can throw these in stir fry. I love cooked cabbage. I'm like you, I like cooked cabbage too. Just even throwing it on the grill is actually, you know, if you have a cabbage and cut it in quarters and throw it on the grill, it's actually pretty good too. So it's just a little bit of seasoning. And of course, stir fries are a good way to, I think, make your family eat some more veggies too, because that's a very vegetable-based dish. So I think that would be an awesome thing to do too.
Well, I think altogether you have one meal here. You're talking about, you know, you have the salmon, you can make a side of vegetables,
and then dessert
you can have some fruit and top it off with some, you know, walnuts or something. So I think it's just definitely a perfect mix. And these are foods that not only help your memory, as you were saying, but they can offer so many benefits.
Oh yeah, for your whole body, the heart. You know,
so I have one quick question, just a personal question, but I'm sure you might wonder too. With these vitamins, where do you typically buy a lot of these at? Is there a good place to buy, like salmon
oil?
Or
I bought that online, but but there are, I mean, and supplements aren't regulated by the FDA, so you just have to trust your supplier, honestly. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's why I push food before pills, obviously, and because, you know, supplements could have a interaction with medications too. So you definitely want your healthcare provider to know you're on these things, especially,
but
you know,
vegetables, fish, all those things, you are good to go.
More Mediterranean eating.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Heather. She always teaches me something new every time. Hey, we're going to have much more coming up in just a little bit.